Hello again. So happy you could join me on this beautiful day. I hope it's a beautiful day wherever you're at. I'd like to start off by thanking all my viewers and subscribers. Really do appreciate it and all the comments you've made. I always try to get back with you as soon as I possibly can. Today maybe I thought we would do maybe a waterfall or something, some colorful scenery. Maybe a snow-capped mountain or where the water's coming from. Who knows, we'll probably play as we go and see what we come up with. Like always, I got a pre-stretched canvas, 16 by 20. What I do is I spray painted it with your local hardware spray paint. Make sure you're in a well-ventilated area and you have a mask on. After I did that, I loaded it up with a thin coat of liquid clear. That's going to help the oils go on a lot smoother. And you'll notice maybe if you missed a spot, when you get to that point, the oils will really drag. They won't blend as easy. And as always, it's a pre-stretched canvas, 16 by 20. And any information on all the colors you'll need to paint along with me, if that's what you choose to do, like always, will come across the screen somewhere right about here. So, that's where we're at. Maybe we'll get some color coming up here, a lighter color. Maybe we're going to put the snow-capped mountain, and then maybe we'll have the waterfall coming down somewhere. So we'll come in and we'll just make this white, and maybe an orange. Get some color in here. Clean that little fan brush off. I use a rose paint thinner. It's always good to do. Some more white again. I really don't know how much of that you're going to see up there. Take this real soft blender brush. Gotta blend this in. Tap it. Then blend it in. Nice. Circular motions. Come into some more white. Brighten that up. Tapping it. Gonna wipe off the excess. That blender brush. We'll come in. Go right along. Something like that. We'll get some clouds stuff going. Cloud formations. daylight. Get a mountain color going. Get a little roll of paint right off the edge, off the palette knife. And we'll come in here and determine where we want our mountain to be first. Ours is right there. Bluer mountain. Lighter blues. Like that to start out with. We'll come in with a blender brush and we'll pull down. Maybe we'll use this brush here. We'll use this brush that we loaded the canvas up with liquid clear. We can pull this. It pulls smoother. Make it as big or small of a mountain as you want, just by how far you want to pull down on this. Palette knife, and then we'll grab some white or some snow-capped mountains, just like that. Light source is right behind there, so we'll come in here, tapping in some spots. Some spots where we think that it might be. Barely tapping. If you barely touch it, the paint that's on there will pull off the white. And all you gotta do is barely tap it. Barely load it up. Let it do all that breaking. That's the way it would look. Little rock formations and stuff. This one comes this way and it goes across in front, and that looks pretty good to me. Now we'll get some blue color, highlight the shadowy part. That blue's got to be a little lighter. And doing the same thing, just tapping it. Just pulling down. Things happening. And you can always come back into some more white where you think you might want. Just like that. Got the different shades down there now. You got some color in here. Where you think that some of that will be. I like that, just like that. Get the blender brush, tap this, right? You want that misty right at the base. Right at the base of the mountain. You want to pay attention to the lay of the land or the lay of the mountain. Have it come right down. Right down the way you think the mountain would be. Maybe we can put some kind of orange clouds. Load this up. Maybe we can have some with more white but a little orange in it. I'm doing is circular motions. All the way across. Maybe that's coming right down by the mountain. Just like that. Maybe in our world we have an eagle. Birds are always nice to put in. Adds a little flavor. Makes it a little bit more interesting. Liner brush just a little bit. Just some white on there. Maybe we can put this off in the distance over here. A bird flying in the distance. Okay, I'm gonna leave that. I'm gonna come in. Put some evergreen trees up here and we're gonna have the waterfall coming down. So we're gonna get some liquid clear. I'm just gonna put it on this brush right here. Liquid clear, some green color. Darker green and some brown. Maybe a touch of black. Darken it up. Like that. We'll come in and we'll do some. Tell you what, I'm going to save that brush for a minute. We'll come into that little fan brush. We'll get some distant trees going first. Leave a space in between so it'd be a layer. Make these bigger trees. So I'm coming down further. Coming down further on the bottom side of it. All I'm doing is tapping. Hope you can see that at home or wherever you're viewing this at. Some more color. All the way across. Just like that. You bring it down further in the front here, you make it automatically get bigger. Tap harder and you get some dark spots in there. Right off. You can do the same thing over here too. Have it go right off the canvas. Have it going kind of wavy. you can darken some of this in, make things closer. Make it real woodsy out there. Kinda like that look. Wonder if I pull that down using the blender brush. Just tapping it. Blending that bottom part, getting that misty look that you'd see. That you would see in the wilderness. Effect, but I also want to put in more maybe another layer. Just tapping it in. Just tapping it in here and there. Come in with the blender brush, pull down, tap it. Pull up, pull down. Woodsy. Okay. Now we can put some land there. And I'll tell you what. I'm gonna come in and let's find out where a waterfall is going to be. When you do this waterfall, it's just like doing the wave on the ocean scenes. Load it just up like that. Maybe our waterfall could come right here. all the way down. Just like that. Now we'll come into some dark color back here. Put some land in, use a palette knife. Maybe this is where the rocks is built up. Get some white. Highlight the top of the mountains, the rocks. I want to miss that a little bit too. Kind of want it to be blended in some. Palette knife. Come into some colors and rocks and stuff. Right where the waterfall might. Different formations. Kind of all the way down. That brush off we use for the mountains, and we'll pull this down. Where you might have the rock formations and stuff there. Now we'll come in to some white. Making that where the rocks are. Maybe we got some up here. Just where it's coming through. Maybe down here we'll load it up with some greenery. Maybe. Maybe we'll finish off the mist down here. Base of the waterfall. Do some of that color. Come into some darker blues. Basin this, use it for the shadow. Clean that blender brush off. Beat the excess off. Just want to come into that white and that shadow color. get some of that going. Clean off that one brush we're using for the white. Blender brush again. Cloudiness in there. Cloudiness. Circular motions and just trying to get that look the way it would look at the face of the more brown. More brown. For the stones. All kinds of things happening right in there. Marbly stuff happening. And we'll get some more white going right along the top here. Okay, got that going on. Now we just need to fill in some of this area here. making some, making a line over here. The water to come through. Then we can fill this stuff in here. So yeah, we can put some trees in here. Where the waterfall is. Just tapping it. Going across, back and forth. Make a big one right here. Take the corner of the brush and just start tapping. And going right down. Back and forth, just the way you think a Christmas tree, evergreen tree might look. Look. Now we'll come in down here and add some things. Down here. Maybe it comes right down over the down over into the waterfall. All kinds of things happening in here. All I'm doing is tapping and filling it in with greenery. Different shades. We'll put some trees in here in a minute. Different shades. A tree coming over here. All the way down. Tell you what, let's just make this hanging over. Just make that one hanging over the whole top of the canvas. Something like that. Now, some mountains and hills, they got some evergreen trees. And things that grow right out from the mountain. So, tell you what we'll do. this in a little bit more here. Fill this some more down here. Decided how I want to fill this in. Let's put a tree in here and see what happens. See what the outcome is. Blended all that in. So we'll just make this a tree up here. Use a liner brush, make some twigs and things, and all this in. Darker and darker. Water in here. Let's do some blues. Blues and blacks. Straight down. Keep pulling it down until you get that misty look. Until you get that watery. Get into some of this color here and go under. underneath. Misty look that we're looking for. Use a blender brush, just a corner of it. Circular motions. Stuff happening down there. All the way across. Now we'll get some white in there. Water lines. I think what I'm going to do is put something more over here, maybe. Maybe over here. Another evergreen tree. Odd numbers. Odd numbers there. Some yellow. Just yellow. Yellow liquid clear. Maybe some liquid white. Just like that. Kunal will come in and we'll highlight some of this. We'll highlight some of that up there. Some yellows, lighter colors. Tapping that in. Kind of tapping it everywhere. More sunlight hitting that one. All the way across. Who knows? Just blending it in. Okay, I'm going to use a liner brush. Come in and make some twigs and some things. Different things happening down there. here. Blend that in. Some lighter colors up there. This can just all be grassy areas. Grassy area that came in over the waterfall. Just like that. It's all dark back there. Lighter there. I'll tell you what, the more you tap on it, it still gives you that highlighted look, but it's not as one area. It blends it more, makes it more look like a highlight. Highlighted area instead of having it pop so much. Got some little things happening down here. Maybe we can have some things happening over there. What I see is some flower time. Wanted to decorate this, get this kind of going a little bit. Maybe there's some right down by the water. Right down by the water. That off. brighter. Lighter blues. Be a flower thing happening. Tell you what we can do. Clean this brush off. Come into some yellows. Whites, yellow. I see things happening over here. Yellow flowers. We can really flower it up. Kind of have them scattered all over the place. Kind of like that, just like that. So on that note, I'm going to call this a completed painting. Signing mine with my last name. Some people put their initials. It's whatever you prefer. I also like putting the year in. I hope you enjoyed this one. I wanted to give you a waterfall effect. Hope you painted along with me. And thanks for watching.